Welcome to CUC's 2016 production of Honk. At this time, we do ask you to turn off all cellular devices as the show is about to begin. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the show.
Thank you. Drake! Drake! It's no good paddling away. I've seen you. And it doesn't do for a duck to look sheepish. It confuses the other animals.
How's it going, Ida? You still sitting? I don't know. It's all right for song.
Well, if you like the sound of it so much, why don't you take a turn on the nest? And wipe your bets. I just did the floors this morning.
Oh, Ida, I'd love to have a crack at sitting on the eggs for a while. But you seem so comfortable up there. It seems a shame to disturb you.
Huh. And what about that extension you promised to build on the nest? It's going to be very cramped in here once the little ones arrive. Especially with that one big egg in the clutch. Goodness knows what size that chick is going to be.
You know, I reckon that might be a turkey's egg.
Oh, Drake.
I had the same problem with my ex.
Here we go.
We had a whole pack of problems with the young ones, I can tell you. They're afraid of the water. She had me running up and down the lake yelling, "Colonel Sanders!" And they still didn't go in.
Drake, how would a turkey's egg get to be in my nest? Must be your side of the family.
Well, we'll just have to wait and see who he takes after then, won't we, dear?
Yes, dear.
Anyway, must fly. I promised the rooster I'd help him hunt chickens. Shall I see you back here?
Well, where else do you suppose I'm going to be? As a duck, when you're stuck, sat sitting in the middle of your nest, then at best you get bored. There goes Drake on the lake. I can see you through the bushes all the time, feeling I'm just ignored. I don't pretend that this is all it's doing. Have the
for me? It's probably making waves down at the local watering pool.
Oh, all right. Auntie Mormor's up now. I'll see you later.
Auntie Mormor? What a weird name.
What a big world it is.
Yeah, far out. I was getting more cramped inside that egg.
Well, don't go thinking this is the whole world. It stretches far beyond the other side of the lake, right into the churchyard. Though I've never been that far myself.
Wicked, let's explore.
Wait. There are one or two nest rules before you paddle off. Number one, no wet-webbed feet in the nest. Number two, you must feather your own nest every morning. Number three, no quacking after sunset. Number four, no plankton between meals. Number five, wait a minute, you're not all here.
Hey guys, there's gonna be another member of the gang.
Oh, quacking is the big one.
Look at the shell on that.
Excellent.
How come he got such a big egg?
Yeah, we all got crammed into a regular shell. That one got a queen-sized ostrich jaw.
It's not fair.
No, Mom,
it's not fair.
Hey, kids. I'm your dad.
Take a good look at him, because you probably won't see him that often. Well, true form, you missed it.
The pitter-patter of the petite patties.
Well, I'm here now. Okay, kids, who's for a swim? What's the matter, Ida? All that sitting, taking it out of you?
There's still one to hatch, Dumbclaw. The big one!
Why don't you see that egg again? Yup, that's definitely a turkey. You'll never get it to go in the water. Just leave it. Oi, cut that out! Come and teach the other ones to swim properly.
You teach the other ones to swim properly. Might as well sit a bit longer. I've sat for so long already, a few days more won't make any difference.
Whatever you say, dear. Okay, kids, last one to the lakes are cooped. Hey, wait for me!
Thank you. flat. Don't be okay.
Thank you.
room, there is no doubt.
Alas, he's become crispy and aromatic.
I'll give it a dab.
I should have a little room. Look at that.
Oh, yes, Maureen, this is delicious. Come along, children, try this. Make way for the red banded duck. Ida, you really are going to have to do something about that. Honk.
Get back. Too big.
It's not fair. Why are you picking on me? I'm hungry, too. Cock.
If they knew just how dearly I would love to
cock.
But it's true, I'm a bird who seems to lack the night. I'm just different from the rest. Can't complain of wanting me to find my best. Different isn't naughty, different isn't bad. So why should being different make me sad? I'm just different.
Mama.
Yes, Beaky, don't step on Downy's foot. She keeps going round in circles. Just a moment, sweetheart. Billy, not such big mouthfuls, and soak it in water first or you'll choke.
Would it be all right if
I... sure, Fluff. I hope you're not just picking out the raisins.
Look, it won't be gone for long. What am I gonna do? And you're hungry, aren't you?
Yes, I am.
That makes two of us.
Come on. Well, if you're sure.
Oh, I'm quite sure.
I don't feel sorry for
it. How should we actually lay that egg? I'll never know. Brings tears to my eyes just thinking about it.
I just think it puts out the wrong message, having someone looking like that paraded around the lakeside amenities.
Do you mind? That is my son you're talking about. There's nothing wrong with him. He just looks a bit different, that's all. And I think that makes him someone rather special. Oh, well said, Ida. I agree. And if I agree, then everyone agrees. Time to leave an apology in order from you two. Wait a minute. Where's he gone?
I thought he was with you.
He was, just a moment ago.
Well, just set. Bill's gone to find a bag and throw over his head.
Wait, that's enough.
Calm down, love. Have you gone far?
He's trying to ask me something.
So he's probably just wandered back to the lake. You know how much he loves swimming.
You're always out telling me first he wouldn't. Is he gone?
Oh, goodness. Okay. Turkey, go look along the milking shed. Marina and Henrietta, go look along the hen house. Ida, go take the duckies down the lake.
The operations from the grain store.
I think of it as home. Now, let's see. Casserole of duck. Duck with cherries. Duck with chestnuts. Duck pate.
Duck pancakes with plum sauce.
Here we are. Duck a la mode.
So, what do we have?
I'm having you for lunch.
Yes, I know we are. I mean, what are we going to eat?
Oh, I'll whip something up. A surprise.
My mother must have been thinking of someone else. She told me to beware of the cat.
Oh, bless her!
Mothers are all the same. They seem to think for some reason it's part of their job description to stop us from having fun. Not my mother, though. No, she's different. Do you know what my mother used to say to me?
No. What?
You can scratch the antique furniture to sharpen up your claws. You can lacerate the cushions if you're ever stuck indoors. You can dig up all the flowers from the freshly planted beds. And with articles of clothing, it's okay to pull some threads. But I remember as a kindergarten little dude, one phrase that left me singularly smitten. You can play with your foot before you eat it. You can chew, watch out before you chew.
I'd like place where it's mocking. Then I make a little cat that's to be dipping down for me, and I make them mocking. And if the other ducklings want to come and join our games, they'd have to make a promise first to stop calling me names.
Oh, I have to forget the way they scolded.
That's enough of that. I don't want to hear another word.
and you are going to be nice to him. Now, Oster Roost.
Your voice that I hear every
you're wasting your time on. You know you are. Apart from which, it's dangerous to go wandering off beyond the churchyard at this time of year.
I will be satisfied until I know the truth. Try to understand you.
Well, you better take a song.
Direction. Sorry, Commander.
Bigfoot, you've trodden in something. How many times have I told you to mind your own business? See to it. Snowy? Never mind. All right, man, at ease. We are about to take part in a very delicate and not to mention dangerous mission.
Oh, one of them, is it?
Our task is one of reconnaissance and reunification.
Oh, here we go. Translation done?
The poor duckling's lost his mum. Bless him.
And we're going to find her.
If that's what he means, why doesn't he just say it?
You can always tell half school friends pigeon English.
All right, men. We are about to take part in an exercise, the likes of which we have not faced before. You're a fine body of peace, and I know you will all give your very best. Good luck.
Peace.
bushes clear. They're putting away their guns.
Are you sure?
On one of my lives.
Very well then. Final check, everyone. Come. And here's a parachute for you.
For me?
What? You didn't think you were leaving alone with the duckling now, were you? No, no, boss, you're coming with us.
Thank you.
No, a people person.
There's some cream for you, Queenie. And there'll be some pork for you, Boba, if you can manage to lay an egg for my lunch. Perhaps a brown one with speckles. Brown I can manage, but I'm all out of speckles.
What's that? There's a dirty footprint on the shag.
Oh, and it's always in a place where it shows. Some people are so thoughtless. Why can't they step on the pattern section like civilized folk?
Never mind where they stepped. My point is that someone has stepped at all. In our house.
And whoever did seem to burst the pillow.
I'm not a burst the pillow.
Oh, my word, it speaks.
What are you? Animal? Vegetable? Or mineral?
Ductable. Or duck. I'm a duckling.
Are you sure you're a duck? Was your mother a duck?
Yes.
Well, she would have been sick as a parrot when she saw you.
Oh, Lumba, that's terribly good.
I don't think I've ever seen such an ugly duckling.
What are you doing in our house?
I was sheltering from the cold. The door's left open and I didn't think it would hurt to step inside.
Not hurt? Not hurt? Let me tell you, the marks you've left on the carpet will dry a field when we grab the carpet fresh. I can't bear the smell of that stuff.
Steady, Queenie, don't upset yourself. It's obviously going through the moat. Poor Mom was running amok. Irrational behavior.
What of it?
I don't think I like your tone, Mr. Poultry, my lad. And mind that, you'll be marking the antimacassar next.
What's an antimacassar?
Well, it's...
I don't know, but it obviously works. There hasn't been a macassar in the house for as long as I can remember.
Oh, that was so funny, Queenie. You're such a funny cat.
Thank you, dear.
Cat? Are you a cat?
Of course I'm a cat.
So, are you going to eat me?
Don't be disgusting. The very thought. I've never been much in the bird butchering business. Feathers. It's like eating a meal and flossing your teeth at the same time. No, no. The old woman butchers me a fresh fish.
But the old woman is a person. Doesn't she hurt you? And you. Your chicken. Why is she keeping you shut inside? Don't you prefer it out in the yard?
Oh, you must be crazy. All that scratching and scraping. No, no, no. I live here right on the couch. Queenie and I are domesticated, you see.
Thank you. and sit and chat, and sometimes I will arch my back and scarce will fly from my fur.
And then we sit and chat, and sit and chat, and sometimes I'm late.
Is that it?
What else is there for civilized folk to do? What do you do?
Well, my absolute favorite thing is swimming. It's so wonderful when the water flows over your head as you plunge right down at the bottom.
Lobot knows all about plunging at the bottom. Don't you dear?
Come on, I'll show you.
Swimming in the autumn? Why? I've never heard of such a crazy notion.
You could use the exercise, dear. Think of your thigh meat. She's got drumsticks like an ostrich.
Well, you haven't exactly been a slave to your step aerobics. It's the least you can do to get your butt.
Gracious, Lobot, you're missing your TV program! Don't talk! She loves watching her antique show.
Where's the remote?
You're sitting on it.
Oh.
6 months on and still no sighting of the duckling who, as you'll remember from the photograph released at the time, can be described as rather unforgettable. Our experts believe he may have undergone some certain changes and have put together a composite of what he may look like today. Some viewers may find this image disturbing.
I know he's still out there somewhere, so if anyone has seen him, please call in.
Mama.
Yes, viewers, we are appealing to you once again. If you have any information, the number will appear on screen.
Is there something you'd like to tell us, dear?
Mama.
Did you run away from home?
No.
Well, there's only one thing to do. I'll call from the kitchen.
I'm sure
you'll go out of it. No, the old woman.
She wouldn't ring her own doorbell. Come in!
Quack, quack.
Oh no, what are you doing here?
Thought I'd cooked my goose, eh? Is that any way to treat your long-lost feather? Father?
Well, ugliness certainly runs in the family.
It's not my father. Don't listen to him.
He is overcome. Son, hug your daddy.
Don't let him near me. Does he look like a duck?
Now. Folk who live in glass houses shouldn't call the kettle black. Or something like that.
He's a cat.
Ha ha ha, children will have their fun. I'm sorry if he's caused you any inconvenience, and I'm so glad you've kept him in one of these. Come along, Ducky. Thank the nice poultry for looking after you.
He's a cat, I tell you, a sly, treacherous, double-crossing. No good cannot tomcat.
It's no good. The line's busy.
Oh.
Hello.
What's the matter? Haven't you got a con to go to?
No.
Didn't you say that his mother was worried? It's best that you start going now.
No.
Oh, I told you he was a tomcat.
A tomcat?
Don't get any funny ideas. We have an arrangement, don't forget.
Tonight, I'd be honored, though I'm not of your ink. If we could get together, maybe share a dish of milk.
Sir, I'd be delighted, though it's true you're scruff. But when one's happy's easy, everything feels rough.
Queenie, you wolf cat!
Thank you.
my son, get that one. It ain't right. I spent weeks feeling beaks. Daddy, 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 I'm depressed. Round the nest, day and night. And what sort of time do you call this?
We sort of lost track of time.
The owl didn't give a hoot.
Well, your father does.
Mama, let us stay out.
Mama's not here. You're grounded.
Ugh, Juano.
And where'd you pick up language like that? I told you not to hang around with that jade bird. He's so blue.
Well, you say it.
That's different. I say it in a mature, adult, and grown-up way.
That means the same thing. When's Mom coming back?
I don't know. And have you preened your feathers today?
We haven't got around to that yet.
What do you mean you haven't gotten around to it yet? What do they teach you these days? You know what happens to birds that don't preen? They sing.
But she is coming back.
I don't know. And did you eat the pond weed I packed for you?
The pelicans don't have pond weed?
No, the pelicans wouldn't.
Will she find it ugly?
I don't know, honey. Okay. I don't know. Okay, it's time for you to boost. Make sure you brush your beaks and don't take all the water. My bill's big enough. When Ida said she'd go, I had to let her. A shame, because this apron suits her better. Where's the joy in motherhood? An endless round of chores that have to be done. And when you think you see the fact that you find an actual fact back to square one.
Shoved her a while ago. Well, I say, please shove her a little bit more. Us,
That's north of here, isn't it?
Yes.
How very interesting.
You!
did. Would she want anything to do with me?
Whoops, pardon me.
Leave me alone.
Sorry, Feathers. Didn't make a jump. Not that there's anything wrong with jumping, of course, so there are runs in the family. Or jumps in the family. Depending on which.
What do you want?
Want?
Go on. Tell me how ugly I am.
Ugly?
There.
Whoa.
I hope you feel better now.
Do you mind if I hop off and come back on again? I mean, have a word with yourself, Feathers. Who am I to call you ugly? Look at me. There, see? I mean, connect the dots. If we're talking ugly, they don't come more aesthetically challenging than me. I know what your trouble is. You've been preening yourself too much.
What do you mean?
You've got down in the mouth! Nothing. Get nothing.
I don't want to be left on my own.
Now that's just downright antisocial. Hang on. I got a human in my throat. I know how you feel, it must not depress you. I started out as a blabogenic, and it's been downhill ever since. I say to myself, I'm just a prince trapped in a frog's clothing. And one day someone will come along and kiss me and release my inner beauty. Then I say to myself, nah, get real! Who wants to French a frog? You know what our trouble is?
No.
Our ambitious is in vogue. That's all. It's a question of taste, that is. But you mark my words. One day up, they'll be in. If you just sit tight on your lily pad, each silly fad will pass. Then those who sport this season's luck will fall flat on their. Ask your mother what it's called. Fashion is a fickle thing. Just you wait and see. It will come when we're in style. Just around the corner, in amongst the fauna, someone's gonna fall for you, though I may be drastic. Trust me, I'm plastic in my heart. Though you may taste that way, wait until you have a fall.
Small.
It's true, just think, whenever.
Coming back.
Listen, Ducky, I have what I think you will agree is a very tempting proposition, one which might just satisfy us both.
Well, I don't like oranges, if that's what's part of the plan.
Look, I'll take you back to the farm, and you'll get to see your mother again for one last time.
Heather Wickedly, right?
Well, you can't have it both ways. Quick, make up your mind.
All right, you're on.
And no funny business. Remember, at least this way you get to see your mother again.
Thank you.
Mama!
Turn into doesn't bear thinking about.
Wait a minute.
Thank you.
flowers for you as well. Well, that's what you think. So that's all I have to say, unless anybody else wanted to say anything. Just wait.